Finally tonight, with the economy healing, Republicans are ramping up the culture wars. Their target now, animated characters. They just love to blame real-world problems on fictional characters. Dan Quayle started the trend 20 years ago by attacking TV's Murphy Brown for being a single mom.
It doesn't help matters when primetime TV has Murphy Brown, a character who supposedly epitomizes today's intelligent, highly paid professional woman, mocking the importance of fathers by bearing a child alone and calling it just another lifestyle choice.
But these days, Republicans are turning against talking sponges.
SpongeBob is talking a lot about global warming.
Clearly, Nickelodeon is pushing a global warming agenda.
Oh yeah, that sponge clearly has an agenda. And they're worried about those Muppets brainwashing our kids with a liberal agenda.
Liberal Hollywood depicting a successful businessman as evil? That's not new. Is liberal Hollywood using class warfare to kind of brainwash our kids?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yes, those Muppets are dangerous. But trends come and go so quickly with kids. Fortunately, Fox Business host Lou Dobbs is up on the latest fads. He's bashing the new Dr. Seuss movie, Lorax, for being too pro-environment.
The president's liberal friends in Hollywood targeting a younger demographic using animated movies to sell their agenda to children. The movie, set to be released nationwide next month, is about a woodland creature who speaks for the trees and fights rampant industrialism.
And Lou, you do know why Fred Flintstone and Barney Rubble have to pedal with their feet their vehicles? Because gas is too high under President Obama.